Hi, everybody. I'm really happy to be with you again for this Capital Market Day. I want to thank you for the time you are taking with us to share on the priorities and the strategies of Schneider. Indeed, this time is important. This time is quite paradoxical. On one side, we are facing together and collectively the biggest pandemic crisis we've ever known. At the same time, I've been titling this presentation Accelerating. Accelerating because time of COVID has been a time of inflection for most of our markets, and the past years have been also a time of acceleration for some of the new business we are putting together. Let's go straight to the point. Today, I'm going to speak about three things. First, our markets and why they're accelerating. Second, our new pillars of growth. Third, our unique operating model, which is supporting our strategy, but also making us fit for a world which is with COVID or post-COVID. Let's first start by the big picture, the big problem we have been tackling at Schneider for the past 20 years: climate change and developing technologies to fight this phenomenon. We are just out of Glasgow, COP26, and the consensus is very simple. We need to do much faster and do more. Why faster? Because everything we do in the next decade till 2030 will have much more value than what we do afterwards. If we look at those next 10 years, we need to do three times more. Today, the sum of the pledges, government, companies that we have put together is only 4 gigatons. If we want to bring the curve of the evolution of the world from where it is today to a trajectory of 1.5 degrees, we need to do three times more. Three times faster, three times more. There is a path. We've been working on that at Schneider for the past 20 years. We can combine existing technologies today to resolve the problem. If you look at the equation, 45% of the solution to carbon emission reduction is in the supply. Replacing fossil sources of energy by low-carbon sources of energy. 55% of the solution is on the demand side, combining electrification and efficiency, digitization principally. Let's face it, the world that this supposes to develop is very different, will be very different. On one side, it's going to be immensely more digital, and we know that, the Internet of Things coming at scale. On the other side, it's going to be much more electric. Today, 20% of what we consume as energy is electric. This world in 10 years' time will be 10% more electric. 30% of what we're going to be consuming will be electrical. Most of the evolution in the next 10 years will happen in buildings and in mobility. There will be even more electrification in the 20 years following. Let's all be prepared to a world which is going to be massively more electric. Let's be practical, and I wanted to share with you one example, the example that we all know because we all have a home or we all have one apartment. Today, we all live in places that were built some time ago. Those places are powered by fossil fuel, they are not automated, and they are connected, not connected really in an interactive dialogue with the grid. Today, as of today, with existing technologies that are already available, we can create homes of the future. They have local generation, which is green generation, they are smart, and they have a permanent communication with the grid. Look at the consequences in terms of results. A home of the future has an energy demand which will be divided by two to three respect to a traditional one. Carbon emission divided by four to 10. Consequences for Schneider is that our part of the market that we can address in a home of the future is five times the market that we can address in a traditional home. Make no mistake, I'm not saying that our market is getting immediately multiplied by five. This is a transition, but we are clearly going to a world which is made of homes of the future. And I've taken the example of a home, but I could make exactly the same example in a building or an industrial facility. Now, the second point of which we should be all sure of, it's not a fashion. It's really a tipping point. It's an inflection, which is powered by the change in government attitudes, where governments are putting incredible stimulus to create a future which is greener. It's also brought along by companies which are signing in thousands to commitments in science-based targets on trajectory of 1.5 degree. But the most important probably change that happened recently is investors, which are holding now CEOs on boardrooms accountable on their extra financial, and especially on their carbon footprint. So be prepared for a future that's going to be very different. But there are four things that we need to do to make this future happen. The first thing is to do 10 times more retrofit, because most of the carbon emissions are not happening in a new build. They're happening in the already existing building or plant stock. And it's only possible to accelerate retrofit if we use massively new technologies. All technologies want, hello, an acceleration. So it's a lot about digitization and energy efficiency. Second point, let's make sure that in developed countries, everything we build anew is built to net zero, using the newest technology, and especially software, to optimize the process of construction. And third, we need to create the future-proof infrastructure which will enable the development of those smart places, namely smart grids, electric vehicle infrastructure. And then, longer term, more innovation is coming along that will make it possible to address the hard-to-abate segments of industries, building, and cities. But what is important to realize here is that 70% of the present carbon emissions can be abated with present technologies. And the urgency is to deploy what we have. Deploy what we have in creating a future which will be more digital for efficiency, more electric for decarbonization, and therefore realizing that the equation of sustainability, smart and green, digitization and electrification goes together. And this explains very largely what we've done at Schneider for the past 20 years, making sure that our persistent strategy was to develop technologies to empower all to make the most of our energy and resources. Bridging progress means energy for all, on sustainability, reducing carbon emissions for the planet we share all. We call it Life is On. And we went through this, and we have become, over time, the digital partner of our customers for sustainability and efficiency. Where are we today? We are a company of 25 billion euros, last picture at the end of 2020, 130,000 employees around the world, on the few characteristics that distinguish Schneider. We are very focused on that combination of energy and automation technology for more efficiency and sustainability. We are also a very balanced company in terms of end markets and in terms of geographies. From the beginning, we have taken the strategy to solve our customers' issues. Our customers are facing incredible complexity, so we have created EcoStruxure as a digital architecture to allow them to become more digital and more sustainable. 2 years ago, I explained to you that we would be going one step further in efficiency to bring our customers one step further in digitization and on sustainability by bringing together four integrations. The one of energy and automation for energy and process efficiency, the one from endpoint to the cloud, connecting every connected product to the cloud through EcoStruxure, the one of the whole life cycle of installation from design to build into operate and maintain, through our portfolio of software. And the last integration is bringing our customers from the traditional way of managing their company side by side to a unified company management. Of course, all of this has provoked a tremendous transformation of our company, and you can expect, as we go forward, to see the level of R&D to sales keeping on increasing as we develop more digital and more software in our business. If we come back to our history, I'd explain to you that we had three phases. First phase, 2003, 2013, 10 years to build a portfolio. 10 years with many acquisitions. In parallel, we already started to integrate those acquisitions. 2008, One Schneider, 2009, EcoStruxure. And that period of integration finished roughly in 2017. And from 2018, we've been scaling all of this to transform our company. And the transformation has been immense, going from 1 billion in digital to 11 billion in digital, reinforcing our world-leading electrical capability, electric business, from 6 billion to 22 billion plus of business, on pivoting the solution that we offer to our customers to more sustainability, which is now representing 70% of what we sell to our customers. Now that's where we are. Now let's look at the next cycle. Let's look at the future. And it starts by the realization, which was a point of my introduction, that our markets are accelerating. And in fact, our four end markets are really well positioned for a significant acceleration. Building in the future will be at least twice more electrical. In data centers, storage, computing, data is going to keep growing on generating new needs. Infrastructure is becoming smart and green, and this is accelerated by the stimuli of the government. And finally, every of our industrial customers has at the top of the agenda digitization and sustainability. So if you look back at the fundamental of our market, the best proxy I find to estimate the growth of our market over the past 5 years is the average of the growth of our peer competitors. On the market, if you look at that, was around 2% of growth over the past 5 years. Good news is that we grew twice faster. We overgrew our competition. Now, if I look at the next coming 3 years, we see a market that will be much more positive, actually probably growing to an average of 4% and allowing much more opportunities for us. Now, adding to a market which is clearly more dynamic than what it used to be in the past years, we've, over the years, created new incremental growth drivers. Those growth drivers are not a parallel universe, they plug into the core of Schneider. And the first of them is, of course, services. And you know that over the past 10 years, we've been investing consistently in services, and you've supported this investment. When we sell a mission-critical product, and many of the products we sell are mission-critical, if we sell 1 euro at the time of the sales, we can generate 2 euros of revenue over the whole life cycle of that asset. So what we needed to do was to track those assets and then serve those assets. And the great news is that now we track many more of those assets which are on the field, but we still serve only a tiny minority of them, around 15% of the assets which are already installed. So we see the potential to keep growing field services twice faster than the average of the group. Of course, we do those services with the purpose of bringing more efficiency, more sustainability, which are the known taglines of Schneider. What we've seen over the past years, and especially during the COVID years, is more services are coming from the need to elevate the level of safety and resilience of installation. Let me be a bit more specific about what we do in services, and I won't go into the detail of this slide, but you see that we can bring services at every stage of the life cycle of the installations of our customers. Thank you for supporting, over the past years, the development of our capabilities in services. We have now thousands of field-trained specialists on the field going every day to the installations of our customers. And the great news is that we have a rate of satisfaction on services which is very high. More than 80% of our customers are very satisfied, both of the service on the level of compliance of safety to the safety rules. Our second growth driver is, of course, software. Software is so central to everything we do. It gives sense to all the systems we are connecting and to all the data we are collecting from those systems. We've been at Schneider very focused on the software we want to develop for our customers. And it's all dedicated to the work we do with our customers. What we do at Schneider with our customers is to develop projects and help them to manage their operations in IT, building, plants, power, and infrastructure. And all of those systems are incredibly complex. So we focus really on two points we want to solve. First, offering a complete and continuous digital thread from design to build, operation, and maintenance, so that our customers have one digital twin, which is a faithful replication of what is happening in their operations. The second problem to solve for our customers is that all of their projects include several domains: industry, infrastructure, power, building, and all of this have to integrate into the real life together. Let's make a simple example. If the industrial department wants to increase the size and the power of a machine, this will have modification induced into the power system. And at the same time, the construction site will need to accommodate that bigger machinery or that bigger motor. We want those changes to be seamless across the domains and across all the phases of life of our customers. So summarize, three domains, three phases. We've over the past years, and thank you for supporting the building of that, we've brought along number of companies that offer the necessary blocks to build those two simplifications for the digital life of our customers. And this portfolio of software interfaces with the physical world through EcoStruxure, through the IoT, the connection to IoT. What we are aiming, in fact, to do here is for the first time to offer to our customers, for their complex projects and operation, a unified asset lifecycle and management, which brings a number of benefits. Of course, one unified digital twin across that lifecycle. One big, huge data federation on which our customers can run their analytics and their algorithm. One unique portfolio of algorithm and AI capability, because we work with number of customers on number of installations, which makes that we have developed those portfolio and those capabilities for other customers. And finally, a unified user experience on a unified software federation. So second growth driver is clearly digitization. Now, what is the main topic on the agenda of our customers? There again, of course, sustainability. And we've developed over time our sustainability service business, which is today the spearhead of what we do at Schneider for efficiency and sustainability. That business today, which is around €500 million of turnover, is made of consulting on digital, using our digital platform, Resource Advisor, Neo Network, on some performance contracting services. We are developing these sustainability services fast today, and we intend to keep growing them double digit as we go forward. Services, software, and sustainability. Those three incremental growth drivers have one common point. They bring us into the life cycle of our customers. They allow us to stay connected with our customers. The other point is that they have a strong relationship between themselves. Software will detect problems. That will create a space for services. Our service teams can connect more installations. That will generate more data and give place to more software. Today, as of today, those activities represent 50% of our business, digitization and services, and we intend to bring it to 60% of our business around 2025. Now, if we focus on that third part, which is software and services, which is even more important because this is where you stay truly connected with your customers. Today, they represent 18% of our total turnover. We ambition to grow it by at least 5% of our total turnover by 2025. And today, when you look at the detail of those two activities, already 30% of the business we do here is recurring revenue. If we look to 2025, we ambition to bring that to at least 45% of the revenue that we have in software and services. So now, those three businesses, they don't live in a parallel world. They really plug in into the core. And to make it more practical, I'd like to share with you this slide, which is showing how software, service, sustainability, and products, and controls combine together for a much higher integration of applications. And rather than speaking about it, I'd like to call a customer live tech to speak about the value of this integration.
The automation challenges that we are facing nowadays are 4.0 industry, the Internet of Things, virtual reality, and of course the sustainability and the green impact that our machine should have. Actually, we don't think there is any difference between sustainability and efficiency. Schneider Electric EcoStruxure solution allowed us to create a new machine that is totally modular, flexible, interconnected, and it's looking at the sustainability, minimizing the energy consumption and making quicker and easier the changeovers.
Now let's go to the next big application of Schneider, buildings. Same story. All of those new activities plug into the core to supply complete solution. And there again, I leave you with the detail of that slide, but I'd rather call Shen Chao of AECOM to speak about what we do together.
At AECOM, we create iconic buildings, not only the look of the building itself, but also the function, the technologies, and the efficiency of the building. Design and technology has to work well together. This is the core of our partnership with Schneider Electric. We work with Schneider on this amazing platform called EcoStruxure. With its integrated building management systems, we can optimize energy consumption and reduce costs. This creates a more sustainable future for the building and provides comfort down to the individual level. But this is not just about individual comfort, it is about working together to build resilient, livable, and equitable communities. Schneider is one of the best partners we're working with in order to achieve what we want to achieve.
Now let's go to my third point, and I want to remind you the unique characteristics of our operating model. Integrated, open, multi-hub, and ESG at every level. And I want to do that because any strategy can be executed if it can be supported by the right operating model. Let's start by number one. We have decided in 2008 and 2009 to be one Schneider EcoStruxure, because our customers want us to simplify their lives. They want one Schneider and one solution for them. This choice of organization, which can be at times demanding, brings benefit for our customers. One customer experience, one digital journey, the biggest data lake for digitization. But it brings also significant advantages for Schneider. Attractiveness for talents at a time when the market is pretty hot, scale for deployment, capacity to position strategically, and especially within our ecosystem, let's say for suppliers at the moment, on simplicity, on cost efficiency, especially when you go region by region. Second characteristics, as we speak about partners, we are the company which works the most with partners. 70% of our products are done with suppliers. 60% of our solutions are integrated by partner integrators. We've also consistently developed our new technology with technology partners doing alliances. And we are bringing together all of those people in exchange, our marketplace where developers, integrators, end users can bring, put business on technology solutions together. Third characteristics is our unique multi-hub operating model, which you will realize is extremely important at the time when the world is more divided by politics, trade, digital, and finally, sanitary condition. And probably the unique characteristic of Schneider there is that our people are really in the regions. We are not a centralized company. And I want to take a detour through the last hub we built, India. I'm very proud that by merging together with Larsen & Toubro, we've made of India, which is one of the most promising places in the world for electrification, digitization, urbanization, and manufacturing. We've done of India one of our major centers in the world. 30,000 employees, 30 factories, present in 500 cities, indirectly in 150,000 cities, on a massive power in terms of R&D. Finally, probably the most differentiating aspect of what we've been building over the past 20 years at Schneider is to become what we call at Schneider an impact company. That has been our compass for formulating our strategy and creating our operating model. What do we mean with an impact company? We think at Schneider, we come at Schneider to make an impact. And for us, an impact company is a company that, number one, is performing. Because if you perform, then you can impact positively your environment. If you don't, you will, want it or not, damage your environment. So performance and sustainability go together. Second characteristic is that we have a commitment to all stakeholders and in all dimensions of ESG. Fourth characteristic is that the strategy, the mission, the added value of our company goes directly to the cause of sustainability. And finally, ESG is embedded everywhere in our model, in our culture, at the global level, but even more important so in the world we live today, at the local level. We were honored that in Davos, earlier this year, beginning of 2021, we were recognized by Corporate Knights as the most sustainable corporation in the world. I would take just one example to show you that multidimensional commitment of Schneider into ESG, taking the climate dimension of ESG. Well, not only we bring 100 million tons a year of CO2 savings for our customers, we have taken ourselves very stringent commitments to be a carbon neutral, no biodiversity loss company at different horizons. We have committed to bring along our Scope 3, our suppliers, and today we have engaged with 1,000 suppliers to cut their emissions by a factor of 2. We have committed to communities in developing countries where we operate to supply electricity, green electricity, to 50 million people, training along 1 million people to the future trade of smart energy. And finally, we offer to you, investors, the promise of 80% green revenue. We've also made sure that our business is built on trust, trust with every stakeholder around us. And that trust is based on the highest level of ethics, cybersecurity, safety, quality, and of course, sustainability commitments. And at Schneider, we really believe that great people make a great company. When people join Schneider, they will certainly every time find something we could correct and we listen to them. But there is a consistent feedback is that Schneider is a people company. People come at Schneider because they want to work for a meaningful mission and in a meaningful way. They want the most inclusive workplace and they want a place where themselves can make an impact, where they can be empowered thanks to a multi-hub model. This is supported by very practical things: incentives, flexibility at work, and engagement to community. Time to conclude. Of course, we recognize that the next quarters will be disturbed in terms of supply chain. But we still see accelerating markets. We still benefit from our incremental growth drivers. And we have this operating model which actually supports them, but at the same time is very fit for a with COVID world. So we stay optimistic. We see that shift to digitization and electrification unfolding and accelerating as we go forward. So our ambition is to go into a phase where we are aiming to sustainable revenue growth coupled with margin and cash expansion. Over the next 3 years, we see an organic growth on average of 5 to 8%. We also plan to expand every year the margin by 30 to 70 bips per year. And finally, we are targeting by 2024 to have a cash generation of around 4 billion euros. Beyond that horizon, and I know you're going to ask me the question, we see a growth that would be 5% plus organic on average across the cycle. And we still see the possibility to further expand both margin and cash generation thanks to the transformation of our portfolio and the growth of our business. Beyond those objectives, I want to share the aspiration we have inside of Schneider, the way we think. At Schneider, we want to grow, and at the same time, we are interested only by profitable growth. So we aspire over time to be consistently a company of 25, around 25. If you sum up the organic growth and the operating margin that we are delivering. And that is a fair reflection of what our business must deliver. Profit and growth at the same time. With that, I'm happy to hand over to the next session, and you're going to have all the details of our objectives with Hilary later today.